In the spring of 1946, Winston Churchill traveled to the United States. He tried to shock Americans out of their complacency. In a speech at Fulton, Missouri, carried on radio, he warned them how the Soviets were acting in Europe.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent. Behind that line lie all the capitals of the ancient states of Central and Eastern Europe. Warsaw, Berlin, Prague, Budapest, all these famous cities and the populations around them lie in what I must call the Soviet sphere.
Churchill's vivid picture of a continent divided by an iron curtain helped change the public mood. Once the press had portrayed an alliance of three equals. Now Uncle Joe was turned into a scheming despot, forcing whole countries into submission. From the east, Soviet cartoonists responded in kind. These crude caricatures were part of a new type of war, in which governments taught whole populations to demonize the other. An American newsreel caught the new tone.
In the background was the growing struggle between two great powers to shape the post-war world. Soviet Russia was expansively stabbing westward, knifing into nations left empty by war. On orders from the Kremlin, Russia had launched one of history's most drastic political, moral, and economic wars, a Cold War. The United States was obliged to help Europe safeguard its traditional freedoms and the independence of its nations. Gone was the spirit of wartime unity that reached its peak on that historic afternoon in April 45 at the Elbe River in Germany. Here, two worlds actually met, but this coalition was to be torn asunder.
The Soviets also recalled the meeting on the Elbe. Their version showed a bloodthirsty American general bent on the domination of Europe.
Старая война окончилась. Началась новая. Война с коммунизмом.
Я вижу другие сны, господин генерал. Мне снится мир.
Пожалуйста. У нас свобода сновидений.